It certainly wasn't a bird or a plane. So what the heck was it? The giant streak of orange was seen blazing its way across the sky of the lower North Island yesterday afternoon. Zooming in from Nelson with his expert insights, we're really pleased to welcome to breakfast Dr Duncan Steel, a space scientist from the Zero Earth Observation Institute. Thank you so much for joining us this morning, Dr Steel. What was it?
Well, it was a meteor. It was a lump of rock from space, travelling extremely quickly, something like 20 or 30 kilometres per second, released a huge amount of energy and obviously shook a lot of people up.
Yeah, OK, so now I'm having flashbacks of some of the movies that I have seen. So how concerned or how unusual is this sighting? And I guess particularly during the day as well.
Yeah, I've only personally ever seen one daytime meteor in my life. So it is a once-in-a-lifetime event. If you did get to see it, a lot of people heard it later from the boom when the shockwave came down. It was extremely energetic. Yesterday I was suggesting it may have been the size of a rugby ball or a basketball. Now American early warning sensors have actually published the data on it to show how energetic it was. It was about 1.8 kilotons of TNT. So to put that in some sort of context, that's about 1/6 or 1/7 of the energy of the Hiroshima bomb. It was a huge amount of energy, but released at about 35 kilometers altitude, shook a few people up, shook a few windows and so on, but didn't actually cause any damage.
Yeah, I guess, so can I go back to the original part of that question? And should we be worried? Should we be concerned about this? And also, could there, now I'm just starting to freak out. Could there be more?
Oh, yeah, there's lots more. The Earth gets hit by about 100 tonnes a day of meteoroids, mostly tiny particles. We don't notice them. I spent a lot of my career looking for asteroids and comets which cross the Earth's orbit, as you see in the movies and so on. The movies are all very melodramatic. Should we be worried? No, I don't think we should be worried, but we should be conscious of the fact that there is a risk due to bigger things than this one. Maybe this was a shot across our bows just to remind us that the Earth is not isolated from the rest of the universe.
Yeah. Dr. Steel, you were saying, you know, this is a once-in-a-lifetime, experience, I guess. So for you then, what was that experience like yesterday, knowing and then seeing the report that's come out on it? What was this experience like?
Oh, I mean, obviously a lot of people were very excited as such and there's some great dash cam footage. Nowadays, of course, with the technology, we've got a lot of people got dash cams or surveillance cameras or whatever around their houses. So there's quite a few good, wonderful pictures of it. And I think it's an interesting thing to look at. There were some wonderful eyewitness reports and ear witness reports that people heard the bang, as it were. One lady reported actually hearing crackling at the time at which it was actually seen. That's very unusual because it needs to be radio waves from the object coming down. And I suggested immediately, I bet you she's got long hair or wears glasses like yourself. And sure enough, apparently she has got long hair. And it seems paradoxical, but indeed your hair can act like a radio receiver and produce that crackling noise from the strong electric field produced. So very peculiar, very interesting. I think it's best just to take a look and wonder and say, wow, isn't the universe fantastic?
Yeah, I love that. I love that outlook. That is absolutely fascinating. Thank you so much, Dr. Steel. Lovely to have you back on the show again. And thank you for breaking that down for us again, Dr. Duncan Steel from the Zero Earth Observation Institute. Tēnā koe.
My pleasure.